Triumphant Family for Christ Ministry.
Can I profess now?
Yes, yes, sir.
I'm asking if we do a draw when I talk to whom, whatever I do.
I'm having drugs.
Genesis 22, 1, 2, then 8, 9 to 18. 2 Kings, chapter 5, verse 22 to 27. Another person, John, chapter 4, from verse 1 to 36. But we can just, we may not read all of them, you can write down. Matthew 26, verse 39. Then the last but not the least, Matthew chapter number 15, verse 8. Genesis 22 from verse 1. And it came to pass after these things that God did tempt Abraham and said unto him, Abraham! And he said, Behold, here I am. Verse 2. And he said, Take now thy son, thy only son, Isaac, whom thou lovest, and guide thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him there for a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell thee of. And they came to the place which God had told him of. And Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order and bound Isaac his son and laid him on the altar upon the wood. Verse number 10. And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son. Verse 11. And the angel of the Lord called unto him out of heaven and he said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, Here am I. Verse 12. And he said, Lay not thy hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him. For now I know that thou fearest God, see, thou hast not withheld thy son, thy only son from me. Thy son, thy only son from me. And in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice. Thou hast obeyed my voice. 2 Kings chapter number 5.
Are we there?
Yes, sir. Verse 22 to 27. And he said, All is well. My master has sent me, saying, Behold, even now, there be come to me from Mount Ephraim two young men of the sons of prophets. Give them, I pray thee, a talent of silver and two charges of garment. Then verse 23. And Naaman said, Be content, take two talents. And he urged him and bound two talents of silver in two bags with two charges of garment and laid them upon two of his servants, and they bear them before him. Verse 24. And when he came to the Torah, he took them from their hand and bestowed them in the house, and he let the men go, and they departed. Verse 25. But he went in and stood before his master, and Elisha said unto him, whence comest thou, Gehazi? And he said, thy servant went no whither. Verse 26. And he said unto him, went not my heart with thee? When the man turned again from his chariots to meet thee, is it time to receive money and to receive garments and olive yard and vineyard and sheep and oxen and manservant and maidservants? Verse 27. Are we together? The leprosy therefore of Naaman shall cleave unto thee and unto thy seed forever. And he went out from his presence a leper, as white as snow. Let somebody read for me Matthew 26 verse 39. Another person, Matthew 15 verse 8.
Matthew 15 verse 8.
Yes.
These people draw near to me with their mouth.
These people draw near to me with their mouth.
And honor me with their lips.
And honor me with their lips.
But their heart is far from me.
But their heart is far from me. Who is there in Matthew 26, 39?
Mm-hmm. He went on a little farther.
He went on a little farther.
Bowed with his face to the ground.
He bowed his face to the ground.
Praying, my father.
My father.
If it is possible.
If it is possible.
Let this cup of suffering be
taken away. Let this cup of suffering
be taken away from me.
Be taken away from me.
Yet I want your will to be done, not mine.
Yet I want your will to be done, not mine. Church, briefly, I want to speak on what I call. Are you a son or a servant? Ask your neighbor, say, are you a son or a servant?
Are you a son or a servant?
He just won't marry me. Shall we bow our heads in prayers? Are you a son or a servant? Open your mouth, say, God, speak to me. Oh Lord, speak to me. Change my life with your word. After today, I don't want to remain the same. Oh Lord, speak to me. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Ask your neighbor close to you, say, are you a son or a servant?
Are you a son or a servant?
Ask somebody close to you again. Say, are you truly a son or you are truly a servant?
Are you truly a son or truly a servant?
Church, I want to ask, is the two not good?
But I want to let you know, we have some, then we have servants. A true son is a person who is highly dedicated, who serves in season and out of season, in covenant and out of covenant. I am talking about a son. Why a servant is somebody who serves for gain, who serves for what will benefit him, for what he will eat, for what he will gain. That is a servant. The place we read made us to understand we have a son who was actually a true son of his father, Isaac. Isaac was a true son. You can have a son that you gave back to. It's a servant. It's not a son.
Oh, yes, my bishop.
So many of us here, we have some children. They don't even listen to you. You get back to them. They are your sons. By nature, they are your sons. You call them my son. You call them my daughters. But in the real sense, are they really sons? They are not sons. They are servants. If you tell them, give me a cup of water, they will grumble. Now let me their house. You don't say this one. But when you tell them, give me a cup of water, I will give you money. You go wrong. These are sons that came from us who are servants in our house. A true son, they try to make sure they serve with their life, with their body, total surrender, total dedication, total everything. Isaac was already a teenager, a young boy of about 17. The Bible said one day God told him, God said, my son Abraham, take your only son, the son you love so much, the son you got after 25 years of waiting for God. Ask your neighbor, say, can you do that? After 25 years of waiting on God, God brought forth a son now. And the boy is now 17. And you are hearing a voice saying, take this son, go and offer him for me on one of the mountains, which I will show to you as a burnt offering. Do you know what it's called, burnt offering? Offering at where? Carry yourself, put charon on top of altar, put fuel. Put fuel on top of the body when you don't put her. Your own son or your blood. Put fire, make it the bone for your present. Can you do that? You're watching me, can you do that? Abraham said, I am a true son of God. Whatever God tells me, whether good or bad, it is good. I go ahead. My brain is too small to reason whether what God is saying is bad or good. I am going ahead. He refused to tell his wife. He said, if I should tell my wife, Sarah, wahala don't burst. Yawa don't gas. Therefore, I will not tell her. He told Isaac, he said, Isaac, say, daddy, say, tomorrow morning we are going to the mountain. We want to go and sacrifice to God. Yeah, that is no problem. We are going. That is, we are going. That was how they went. But now, how tedious it was. The Bible says, after they have gone so far for about 3 days, the journey was not here. Church, are they done?
Everybody,
I feel like preaching to you this morning.
Preach to me, my bishop.
After they have gone after about 3 days journey, Abraham told the servant, he said, wait for me here, because if their eyes see what I'm about to do, they will call me a ritualist. I am not a true man of God. They will call me a ritualist. Make me stay behind. Isaac, follow me. As he asked, daddy, life day here, see who day here, my matches, the fire, the everything, they but where the animal now? My brother, Abraham said, God will provide. Actually, he had it in mind. You are the one, Lord. You are the one. They were going to the mountain. When they got there, God wanted to test Abraham. Church, if you are a true son, you need to be tested. And God will test your faith. Don't think that salvation can be gotten so cheap. No, salvation is not cheap. Somebody else has already died for your salvation, which is Jesus Christ. He has already shed his blood on the cross of Calvary for I and you to be saved. And before you can make it, make that heaven, it is very easy. But you have to make up your mind. If you don't make up your mind, you are in the church. My brother, you are doing what you cannot finish. You have started a battle you cannot win. Make up your mind once and for all. That ends everything. That is why there is a song that says, we are you, mamu nase, oh, why, hey, oh, waki mole nase, oh, wow, no, go, oh, we are you, mamu nase,
oh, why, hey, oh, waki mole nase, oh, wow, no, go,
salvation, mamu nase, oh, why, hey,
hallelujah.
When you hold God and make up your mind, say, God, I will serve you till I die. Whether it is bad, whether it is good, whether it is rough, whether it is plenty, in anything, any situation, you are my God. I tell you, salvation will be easier. To serve God will be easier. But when you say, what? I move. If it be like this, I move. It will be hard. It will turn to in here. It will turn to what? In here. Abraham made up his mind. Anyhow. He never knew that God was testing him. God can tell you to do something that is hard, but not something that is impossible. He's the only one qualified to do the impossible. Why God can do something that is hard? For a Christian to make heaven, my brother, for you to succeed in God's hand, you will pass through what? Three tests. Three what? Three processes. Number one, tests. God will test you. He will test your faith. Then number two, God will trust you. He will test you. After you pass the test, he will trust you. After he has trusted you because you passed the test, he will entrust you. He will do what? He will entrust you. These are the three processes. When God is testing you, my brother, it will look as if you are a jaya. Look at that bomb, man. When you get back to children, you look as if things are bad. You are taking care of them, schooling them, trying to make sure they eat food, they do everything. But if you look as if you are a fool, but when they grow up, my brother, you will see the glory. That is how it is. But after everything God has trusted you, I tell you, things will begin to flow. People will begin to nickname you. They will begin to call you names. Do you mind them? You don't mind them. Then after everything, God will not entrust you. You will be a blesser. You begin to bless people. You begin to what? You begin to bless others. That is entrustment. God has tested you. You pass. He has trusted you that anything I put in your hand, this guy can manage it well. Then he has entrusted you now to bless others. These are the three processes. God trusted Abraham. At the end, when God saw that Abraham was actually real, not just faking his salvation, he said, in blessing, I will bless you. A true son is always blessed at the end. He's always blessed at the end. How do you make up your mind to yourself? So many of us here, so many of you listen to the sound of my voice. You are watching me right now. Hey, when your pastor sends you a message, tell you what to do, are you not looking for what to gain? Some pastors, let me tell you, most of the problem of so many pastors are their sister pastors. Church, I don't know what I'm talking. Assistant pastors. But not all the assistant pastors. So most of the problem is their assistant pastors and the deacons and the deaconess, people that are close to pastors. Are we together, church? Can I offend you with the truth?
Offend you with the truth, my bishop.
Let me tell you, let me talk to you, church. If I can't talk to you as a spiritual father, I fit not to be a spiritual father.
Oh yes, my bishop.
God is a master.
Jesus is the master.
They are so close to the man of God, they have no regard, no respect. There is no, look at it, nothing. They see him every day. He said, Birani. Yes, sir. He said, yes, sir. Pastor. Oh, my said, Birani. Welcome to that. My brother, you are acting in the house of God. You must repent. If you are serving, you are in trouble to the work of God. I tell you, you are a servant. You are not a soul. God is looking for a soul. God is looking for a source. Church, there is a level of sonship. When you get back to your soul, you discover that your son is so dedicated, working with you. That's a soul from your boy now. Are we together? There is a level you will grow to. You will make your son to become your friend. Friendship is the highest relationship so far. So I don't know whether they yarn.
Yes, my bishop.
Can I yarn?
Yarn, my bishop. My bishop.
Friendship is the highest level of relationship. There are some things now. Your sons know, you tell them, but your friend know more secrets than your sons. Two of us,
you, my bishop.
But there is a level you will trust your son, that is from your boy, or your pastor, or your workers, or all of them. Then you will not tell them, come. Look at this. Some secret things. Secretly, that is now the level of friendship, no longer the level of sonship. Jesus said, I am no longer calling you a servant, because a servant doesn't know what the master is doing. I am calling you my friend, because a friend keeps secret for each other.
Yes, my bishop.
Mikuza, kuza.
I hear that one.
Igrogo, my bishop.
Oh, yes.
Lesetani,
power.
The devil is a bastard.
Jesus is the master.
The sonship, Jesus was the true son of God. That is why even though God tell him, he said, son, you will go to the earth, go and die for the sin of mankind. Jesus said, die? Habai, oh, how is you? Die? I wish now once now, don't shoot, boy. You don't die. You know, quick and cry. It's easy. Church, are we together?
Yes, sir.
Hey, that guy, don't cut him in once. No, just fall. You don't even know how it happened. You don't pick him, cry. Better. But this one is enough flogging, enough disgrace, enough butchery with Bilala. Hey, when Jesus saw this kind of problem is going to pass through, but God has already given out his word. When your spiritual father speaks a word, do you argue with him? You say, no, sir. So many of us do argue. So many of you don't argue. Sons doesn't argue. Sir, as far as from you, no problem. I will do anything. Jesus said, no, I will go. Papa, you have spoken. He came down from heaven after he has evaluated everything. How he's going to die. He came to the earth. He started preaching. He started doing the word. At the end of everything, when the time was fully come, he went to the Garden of Gethsemane. He knelt down. He said, Father, I wish this cup, this suffering, this problem I am seeing ahead could pass over me. I wish. But after the prayer, he canceled the prayer. He said, oh Lord, forget, don't answer that prayer. Let your will be done, not as I will. That is a true son of a father.
Oh yes.
That is a true son of a father.
Yes, sir.
I hear that when you do that. Can you do that? But the Bible says, from the place we read in the book of 2 Kings, there is a servant, another servant, Gehazi. Elisha was a true son to Elijah, spiritual son. Are we together? Elisha served Elijah until he gained the double portion of his power. Jesus did the work of God until his name was accredited with power. That today, as the measuring of that name Jesus, every knee will bow. Why? Because you obey the Father.
All the power, Bishop.
Abraham honored God so far to the extent even Jesus came from his lineage. Jesus is the son of Abraham.
All the
power. All of us, we are part and parcel of Abraham's family. Why? Because he honored God. He said he was not looking for his own. So many of us come and work in the church. Will they pay me? Come and clear church. What will I gain? I better go to job. Pastor, go call. Forget pastor. Any responsibility in church, you know how to dodge it. You have the best techniques. Tell them to keep on dodging.
Keep on dodging.
Keep on dodging.
Keep on dodging.
Be wise in your own opinion.
Be wise in your own opinion.
Tell them to say, be wise in your own opinion.
Be wise in your own opinion.
A day is coming for you.
A day is coming for you.
There is a day of remembrance. So many of us, when you hear the voice of your pastor, everything is announced in the church, you will not see them. Everybody will feel busy. I tell somebody, you don't know whether you are good or bad until the day you will be doing something. When you are doing something, that is the day you will know whether you are good or you are bad.
Prophecy time.
Can I talk to you?
Yes, ma'am.
You need a word. If I don't pray for you, you need deliverance. Yes. As you know, say you need deliverance.
Yes,
ma'am. Cherish. Cherish. I go something something.
Agbokauda.
Clap of feet to Jesus.
Is from Sabo. I mean Afuze area.
Yes,
you are from Sabo?
From
you are from Onwa? But I am seeing you in Irukpe. What have you to do with Irukpe?
I'm a student of Abu Sali University.
Okay, where did you rent?
At Abia.
You stay at Abia?
Abia.
Irukpe.
Celebrate Jesus! All the power, Bishop! You were
born a professor.
Professor!
In your life, they don't scatter your life, finish.
It's true, no.
They don't scatter and finish.
Power! Celebrate Jesus!
I want to join you. You will succeed.
Amen.
But their intention, this, look at it. There is somebody from your house. I mean, your father's house. Powers from there. There is somebody representing the power who carry your matter when you were born. Right? Since when you were born. Now this problem starts.
True, sir. My father is a native daughter.
You say?
He was a native daughter.
Your father?
Yes.
Clap of feet to Jesus.
But I will deliver you. Do you know what? I am seeing your name. I am seeing your name in the altar. Look at it, in a spiritual altar. In a spiritual altar. In a spirit, if not God, you're supposed to take after your father.
Yes, yes, that's true.
You have a brighter destiny. After this prayer, I am seeing a girl. Look at it. I am seeing a girl sent from demonic world to follow you, to bring you down. Because now, as I'm talking, for long you have been looking for this deliverance.
Yes,
talk to me loud.
It's true, man of God.
For long you have been looking for this deliverance.
It's true.
Now that you are receiving it, after now, I am seeing them. They are sending a girl, fine girl.
Heavenly.
Hello.
Hi.
From school. Travel for back. Travel for front.
Heavenly.
Thank you, Lord. I blow that forces from your father's house out of you.
Power.
Alpha, God bless you. Oh my aunt, mama. Up go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, no?
Hey.
Clap of feet to Jesus!
Upopa, ole le, si we biole, o jionore wo.
Ole no.
Eh? Number one, listen. Ono jionore wo, obe John.
Ono jionore
wo. Ole John.
Ole
John. Upa Jeva Matthew.
Eh?
My metamania. John, Matthew, Odion, Evelyn, listen, Evelyn, Dora, Rebecca, Ifiegbe. Ah,
somebody shout power! For DJ Hot.
Triumphant Family for Christ Ministry.
Can I
profess
now? If he will do a draw, whatever happens,
I'm having trust.
Jesus is the master. Not when you.